There's several main takeaways to keep in mind. I think the first one is that given the remarkable growth in the 65 plus population that's coming down the road this decade, that we don't have any more a single senior generation. In fact, the whole thinking about what it means to be a senior is changing, and in fact, that term is no longer useful. In fact, what we have now emerging are three generations over 65. Those 85 and older, members of the greatest generation, grew up during the Depression, fought World War II, a very conservative financially generation. The generation that's crossing the threshold of 65 now is the front edge of the baby boomer generation. Really, the first half of the baby boomer generation will cross the 65-year-old threshold this decade. And that's going to change all thinking about what it means to be in someone who's in their 60s or 70s, because this is a generation that since the 1960s has disrupted everything that they touched at each age group. They're the ones who were the leaders in the civil rights generation, the protests against the war in Vietnam, rock and roll, women's liberation, on and on, the environmental movement, and the disruptive technology that we are continuing to see unfold before us. So if you talk to them, it's very clear they don't see themselves as seniors. They actually resent the term. And they're going to live longer than any generation before, and they have more energy at 65 than any generation before. So it's a remarkable shift. And they're going to do unprecedented things. In between is what's known as the silent generation. They're in their 70s, late 60s, 70s, early 80s now. And they basically have a foot in both of the other generations. Some of them are very conservative. Some of them are Tina Turner, Mick Jagger, people like that, who have helped to create the new culture as well. So they are a good group to watch to see what trends may be emerging that the baby boomer leading edgers will be following. Another takeaway is that a large percentage of, and perhaps even a majority, of those over 65 now and who will become over 65 in this decade will not have enough personal savings to support them through their ever longer lives. The result is they will rely on Medicare, Medicaid, and Social Security. So that social net, safety net, is going to be more important over the course of this decade and the next decade than it has ever been before. And this, of course, comes at a time when there is greater pressure on federal resources and when their kids, the Generation Y, those in their 20s, early 30s, and younger, are facing the most difficult economic times of any young generation since the 1930s. So that's going to be a defining political debate. Where do we put limited resources? How do we support this group over 65? How do we support the younger people that will be necessary for our economy and for our kids?